الله بركاته، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Sometimes you work hard for something to prepare for a conference, for a lecture, for a course, working day and night, maybe working 25 hours a day for a busy week, not one day, a week. And at the end, who will climb the stage? The manager. Who did nothing, صح؟ Shaking hand, gift to the guest, and you are, maybe you are sleeping after one full week. You are sleeping in your at work. Don't worry, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-alim. The name tonight, inshallah, we are talking about al-alim. The all-knowing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-alim. People don't know who was preparing everything. They are appreciating the manager, the boss who was coming at the end for a gift or for a short talk, 5 minutes. But who was preparing this short talk? Who wrote for him? Who booked the hotel, who booked the food, and who was behind all these things? You, or maybe few people, unknown for the audience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything because He is al-alim, the all-knowing, the knower subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the names, the great names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-alim. Jawhari rahimahullah said, al-alim, or the meaning of al-alim, okay, from al-ilm, the one who knows, ya'lam, wa ya'rif, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we say a person who is allama, this is called sighat mubalagha, too much knowledge. Too much knowledge. Allama. Okay? And also the word al-alim, it is also sighat mubalagha. Yani, the word, what is the verb? Ya'lam. Okay, what is the one who has ilm? Alim. Alim. But if he has more ilm, more knowledge, alim. Too much knowledge, allam or allama. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-alim. Okay, you'll find in the Quran, allam, alim. Okay, but they are not names by themselves. Okay, they came with idafa. You'll not find, yani you can say Allah is al-alim as a name. Allah is al-allam, it is not like that in the Quran. But what you will find in the Quran? Allamul ghuyub, idafa. Okay, not alone. Or the name al-alim. You will not find Allah is al-alim. You will find alim al-ghayb wa shahada. Okay, so yani, some scholars say that, yani, they are names, but with idafa, yani with something addition. You add it with something, not alone, but al-alim by itself. Allah is al-alim. Khalas, full stop. This is full sentence. But Allah is alim. Sorry, Allah is al-alim. You name someone abd al-alim, abd al-allam. It is not a name by itself. طيب. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-alim. The one who has too much knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It came in the Quran, more than 150 times. Or to be precise, 157. 157 times. قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. The angels. The angels. سبحان الله. At the beginning of the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah. وتمت كلمة ربك صدقا وعدلا لا مبدل لكلماته وهو السميع العليم. قد فرض الله لكم تحلة أيمانكم والله مولاكم وهو العليم الحكيم. And the Quran many times, as we mentioned, 157. But the word, the name, or let's say the word al-alim or alim, it came 13 times, 13. عالم الغيب والشهادة فتعالى عما يشركون. إن الله عالم الغيب والشهادة إن الله عالم غيب السماوات والأرض. عالم الغيب فلا يظهر على غيب أحد. 13 times. علام الغيوب 4 times. يوم يجمع الله الرسل فيقول ماذا أجبتم؟ قالوا لا علم لنا إنك أنت علام الغيوب. سورة مائدة. سورة التوبة. ألم يعلموا أن الله يعلم سرهم ونجواهم وأن الله علام الغيوب. Too much knowledge of the unseen. الغيوب. قل إن ربي يقذف بالحق علام الغيوب. In the Sunnah also, you'll find this name in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have the hadith or this dhikr, we say it in the morning and evening. Bismillah الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. And also the hadith about reading the Quran in the Salah. The Sunnah to start, أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. The sunnah you start in the salah sometimes, okay, or generally in the qira'ah, in your recitation, when you start with isti'ada, you can say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. But the sunnah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزي ونفخي ونفثي. So it is in the, there in the Quran and in the sunnah. عالم also in the sunnah. طيب, the hadith of dua, the beginning of the salat, okay, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned this in قيام الليل. اللهم رب جبريل وميكائيل وإسرافيل فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة. Again, the word عالم, not alone, العالم, no. عالم الغيب والشهادة. Another hadith, قل اللهم فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة. The word علام, it came in hadith Bukhari. The famous hadith about the استخارة. اللهم إني أستخيرك بعلمك وأستقدرك بقدرتك وأسألك من فضلك العظيم فإنك تقدر ولا أقدر وتعلم ولا أعلم وأنت علام الغيوب. سبحان الله. When you read this dua, because we are incomplete, we are not perfect, we are ignorant, that's why we need استخارة. Because I am not sure 100%, this is good for me. Yes, I do my study, I do my work, paperwork, and I check with my friends, this car or this car, no, I will buy this car. But before buying this car, you make this dua. اللهم إنك تعلم ولا أعلم. Okay, but we have knowledge. I wrote books, I attended many classes, I finished PhD, but still you say, I don't know. اللهم إنك تعلم ولا أعلم. In the Quran, والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. How we don't know? We have knowledge. But relatively our knowledge, nothing. For example, if you have 200 KD here, 200 KD here, and this pocket, and your account you have 10,000 dinar. Okay? Then someone came to the masjid or one of your friends or someone talking to you. He said, I have 1 million here, 1 million here and 10 billions in my bank account. And in another country, another 10 billions. Then you will say, I have nothing. Why? Relatively, you have nothing. Relatively. So in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned the hadith Musa and al-Khadr. Both of them, prophets. Alayhi salatu wasalam. And Musa, one of the greatest prophets, the five greatest prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, you go to al-Khadr to seek knowledge from al-Khadr. So imagine the knowledge of Musa. Ilm. He is alim. Musa is alim. Okay, can we name a person alim? Yes, you can. Okay, Yusuf alayhi salatu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Yusuf in Surah Yusuf, alim. Qala ja'alni ala khazain al-ard. قال اجعلني على خزائن الأرض إني حفيظ عليم. You can trust me and also I have knowledge. So no problem if you mention wallahi this brother, this sister, عليم. عليم. This is okay. طيب. So موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام great messenger. Allah told him you go to الخضر. You seek knowledge from الخضر. Why? Because when they asked Musa, do you know anyone has knowledge more than you? He said no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, no, there is someone has knowledge. You go to him and you seek knowledge. So when he met al-Khadr, they were chatting together and there was a bird. He took something from the sea. He said, "Ma ilmi wa ilmuka fi ilmi Allah." My knowledge in addition to your knowledge. The knowledge of Musa. Alayhi salatu wasalam. In addition to the knowledge of Al-Khadr, two prophets. If you compare my knowledge with your knowledge, the other side, the knowledge of Allah, it is like this drop, the peak of this bird. Does it decrease anything from the sea? Nothing. So this is the meaning, Wallahu ya'lamu. وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Allah knows and you don't know. طيب. This is one of the main names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sorry, this is one of the main names of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الطبري رحمه الله تعالى said about this ayah about the angel سورة البقرة. قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم The all-knowing, al-hakim, the all-wise. He says, Tabari, إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ يَا رَبَّنَا our Lord, al-alim, the all-knowing, مِنْ غَيْرِ تَعْلِيمِ You are the all-knowing without learning. We have knowledge, but from where? From learning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أَخْرَجَنَا مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِنَا لَا نَعْلَمُ شَيْئًا Okay, we were born from the wombs of our mothers. No, nothing. How much of knowledge you have? Nothing, 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 zero. But at the beginning, you start to learn how to suck the milk from your mother. Then maybe after 4 or 5 months, how to shift from one side to other side. Then how to walk, you talk. So you know nothing from the beginning. So this is one of the big differences between the knowledge of Allah and our knowledge, that the knowledge of Allah from, not from ta'lim, not from learning, our knowledge from learning. So Tabiri said, his knowledge of Allah, of our Lord, من غير تعليم, بجميع ما قد كان وما هو كائن. The past and the future or the present and also with the future of course. وَالْعَالِمُ الْغُيُوبُ دُونَ جَمِيعِ خَلْقِكَ And you know the unseen and your creation don't know. None of your creation knows the unseen. So and here the point that Allah, when we speak about the name Allah, Al-Alim, He knows the past, the present, the future. He knows the past, before our creation.
He knows the generation of my father, my grandfather, the generation of the companions, the generation of Isa, alayhi salam, Musa, Ibrahim, Adam, before Adam, the jinn. Before the jinn, the throne. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything. He knows the present, what is happening now. He knows the future. And also, وَيَعْلَمُ مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ لَوْ كَانَ كَيْفَ يَكُونَ. He knows what did not happen. If it happened, how to happen. وَلَوْ أَرَادُوا الْخُرُوجَ لَأَعَدُّ لَهُ عُدَّةً. لَأَعَدُّ لَهُ about the hypocrites. وَلَوْ أَرَادُوا الْخُرُوجَ لَأَعَدُّ لَهُ عُدَّةً وَلَكِنْ كَرِهَ اللَّهُمْ بِعَاثَهُمْ. If they like to join you in the army Tabuk battle in the night here, they would prepare for that. But Allah hated, Allah disliked for them to be with you. وَلَكِنْ كَرِيَ اللَّهُمْ بِعَاثَهُمْ فَتَبَّطَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them to stop and not to join you. وَلَوْ أَرَادُوا الْخُرُوجِ. If they would like. So Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they joined, they did not join. But if, what will happen? Do we know? We don't know. The companions don't know. Allah knows. How? He said, لو خرجوا فيكم ما زادوكم إلا خبالا. If they were with you in this army, they will make your army weaker or weak, or they will cause troubles. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the kuffar, وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُوعَ. I'm giving examples from the Quran about this part. The scholars say Allah knows the things did not happen. If happen, what, how it will be? The kuffar, they tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give us the chance to come back to dunya. We will give charity, we will do good. They claim, if we have the chance again after death, we will show you, oh Allah, how we will be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ رُدُّوا, if it was for them to come back, لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُوعَ, they will do it again and again. He means, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the disbelief. So Allah knows what will happen. Because you know, so, and this is a very important point. How many times, I studied medicine. If I have the chance, I go back 30 years, I will join this college. I will study business. If I study business, I will be a millionaire. Or I will use my money in da'wah for Muslims here and there. Am I sure if I study business or engineering, how it will be? I don't know. Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a very important concept. And it gives you comfort in your life. Peace, tranquility, submission. I mean the issue of knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah knows everything. Al-Khattabi, rahimahullah, said, Al-Alim, huwa, the one who knows, as-sara'ir wal-khafiyyat, the hidden things. والخفيات التي لا يدركها علم الخلق. The one who knows the hidden things that the creation don't know. إنه عليم بذات الصدور. Allah knows what is inside your heart, what is inside your chest. How many times we speak something, but what we hide is totally the opposite. السلام عليكم, كيف الحال, how are you, inshallah, yes, I'm coming next week. Next week I'm traveling, not coming here. Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala. الحليمي رحمه الله said العليم معناه means the one who knows what his creation can perceive, can realize by their minds and their senses. The vision, the hearing, and also the things that they cannot perceive. Okay, I can know what you, yani, if you speak, I can hear you, I can understand you. But there is a cat talking to another cat, I don't understand. Or maybe one insect speaking to another insect, I cannot hear them. Not only I cannot understand, I cannot hear them. Allah knows everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, said about the ayah, Alim al-ghaybi wa shahada, the one who knows the unseen and the present, what we can witness. Ay, he knows everything, what his slaves can see, and what his slaves cannot see. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For us, it is different. A big difference. Now I can see you. I witness that Rafiq, Umar, Mubin, you are here. I witness. But who's there? The woman's side or outside masjid? I don't know. Why? Because this is ghaib. This is unseen. السعدي رحمه الله said about the name العليم الذي أحاط he added a very important point الذي أحاط علمه بالظواهر والبواطن والإسرار والإعلان. His knowledge أحاط يعني it is a knowledge with control, with full knowledge. Okay, now I have knowledge about this mobile. Okay, it is Samsung, it is, let's say, half tera, it is 5G, 4G or 5G, the screen size, okay, but there are many things I don't know. Even the one who made this mobile, he missed a lot of things. How many times, the one who made the car, he doesn't know how to fix the problem in the car. You hear sometimes they call, for example, those who have Nissan Altima 2016 until 2020, they should go to the garage. صح? We read this sometimes. Why? Because the factory itself, their knowledge about what they are making is incomplete. Subhanallah. So they don't have ihata. Because what's mean ihata? Ihata from like muhit. You encircle, يعني you surround your knowledge, that thing, to know everything about this item. We don't have everything about this item. Even we don't have the knowledge about ourselves. What do you know about yourself? Okay, I know that I like to drink cold water, not the hot water. I like chicken, I don't like fish. Okay, I know these things. But do you know how many cells inside your body? I don't know. Even you don't know what is the size of your liver, your heart to the left side or to the right side. I don't know. How many times my heart is beating? I don't know. Okay, I can check one time, but I don't know 24 hours. So your body, you don't know. Subhanallah. Allah knows everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, there is a difference between having a knowledge about something and having a full knowledge. Allah has the full knowledge about everything, not like us. Even if I tell you, you take the mobile and you spend 1 month to study the mobile, you cannot know everything about this mobile. You cannot. Subhanallah. So Allah, here Sa'di said, الَّذِي أَحَاطَ عِلْمُهُ His knowledge encompassed that الظواهر, what is apparent, and البواطن, what is hidden. والإسرار, the secret, والإعلان, declaring. Also he said, وَالْمُمْكِنَات, and what is possible. في العالم السفلي والعالم العلوي. This world and the upper world. The world of the jinn, the angels. Past, future, present. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll find this name subhanallah in some of the ayat with other names. Yeah, for example, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّ فَتَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. واسع يعني wide, vast, سبحانه وتعالى عليم. Also another ayah, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. How? Because سعة فضله وعطائه وجوده راجع إلى علمه. So again, what is the ayah? الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. Shaitan telling you, be careful. When you give charity, you will be poor. This is the shaitan. You are thinking to give only 1 dinar. Be careful. If you give 1 dinar, then tomorrow also you will give another dinar. After tomorrow, 1 dinar. Okay, this is dinner for your family, lunch for your family. This is for benzene, petrol for your car. So subhanAllah, the shaitan is reminding you not to give. الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء, telling you to be miser, stingy. والله يعيدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا. Allah promising you forgiveness وفضلا, favors. والله واسع عليم. Allah is واسع, his provision wide. Without end. Alim, all-knowing. He knows where to put his rizq. Sometimes, why this guy is, subhanAllah, ignorant? He doesn't know how to write. Some people, subhanAllah, if you give them the pen, you tell them, write your name. He cannot. How much money? Subhanallah. And the other guy, he has master degree. Begging people here and there. How? Why? Allah knows. We don't know. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows where to put his rizq, his provision, his sustenance. Don't worry. Okay? And don't object the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and also in the ayah, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling, don't think that anyone is giving, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him everything according to his knowledge. Allah knows where to put his rizq, his money, his wealth, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his message by choosing the messenger. Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalata. Because, you know, the kuffar objected that why Muhammad was the messenger, alayhi salam, why Allah chose Muhammad? Allah knows where to put his message. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-alim, al-qadir. وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَكُمْ ثُمَّ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْضٍ الْعُمُرِ لِكَيْ لَا يَعْلَمَ بَعْدَ عِلْمٍ شَيْئًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ. The other ayah, أَوْ يُزَوِّجْهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ. To tell you what العليم, the all-knowing, القدير, the power. From القدرة, the power. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the message here? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows and he can do. How many of us, we have knowledge but we cannot do? I have knowledge. I know this is good procedure, perfect procedure, but I cannot do that. Allah knows and can do. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his knowledge is wide and vast. والله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. والله بكل شيء عليم. In everything. Allah knows. Subhanahu. He knows everything. Another ayah. This is Surah Hujurat. Surah Al-Hajj. أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He knows what is in the heaven and the earth. Another ayah. قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ شَهِيدًا. يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. In the heavens and the earth. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you notice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many ayat about his knowledge in details. Because this is important. It is important. Maybe some people say, خلاص, it is enough to say, والله بكل شيء عليم. Allah knows everything. Okay, it is enough. But when you have confirmation emphasizing, this is useful for our knowledge and for our faith. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى says ويعلم ما في البر والبحر. He knows what is in the desert and the sea. And he knows وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها. حجي رفيق, I think I should stop. I feel it is difficult. Okay. Sorry, brothers, sisters. I feel it is difficult to continue. Inshallah, يعني, we mentioned the, يعني, about the name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. العليم. Inshallah, we continue next week, بإذن الله. جزاكم الله خير وصلى الله وسلم على محمد.